Are you a fan of Home and Family? If you're in the Los Angeles area and would like to be a part of our audience, send us an email at hnfaudience@gmail.com. Audience members must be 12 years of age and older, and groups of up to 4 people are welcome. We'd love to see you here in our home.
Right now, let's make a deal.
Okay, let's make a deal.
Right?
What's the deal? No deal.
I had nowhere to go with
okay,
that.
Okay, I know.
You know that show, though? I remember watching this when I was a kid. It's been on the air 52 years.
Wow.
Well, it started 52 years ago. This is a new version that's out now, and it's in its 6th season. Do the math. There's carry the 1, 4. It's hosted by Wayne Brady, co-hosted by our guest today, sitting in the hot seat. Jonathan Mangum is here.
Oh, Jonathan.
So... although back when I watched, they didn't have Twitter followers, but you guys have like almost 200,000 people following
us. We do. It's crazy.
What? Why? Why?
Why? The show is so fun. It's just like it's like a party. It's look at these crazy people all dressed up, and sometimes they don't even know what they are. Like that guy. Like,
what is
that?
Who
wears a top hat and a red nose? People just love the show. It's so much energy and excitement, and so they come back and watch, and they follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and we actually beat, I think the Wheel of Fortune had the most Twitter followers, and I think we recently topped
them. That?
So I think we're the top Twittered.
Wow. What's the secret?
I think it's just, you know, one thing that they let us do, Wayne and I have toured for many, many years doing comedy together, and our show is kind of a PG-13 to R show. It's not a family show. It's an adult comedy show. And they didn't want us to feel like we were trapped in daytime having to stick to that. So we can do anything we want. If they say anything you want, do anything you think is funny, and we'll just cut it. So to Wayne and I...
So basically, there's no show
there's
yet.
No show.
There's 3 minutes to work with.
Basically, yeah. But they'll cut out the stuff. And so to Wayne and I, it feels like we're doing, you know, fresh stuff, and then they cut out the stuff that isn't appropriate, which is a lot. And
the editors must be very busy.
Well, at the Christmas party, they bring out all the bits that are out of the show.
And if you haven't seen the show lately, you need to take a look. And we're here. That's what we do. For you, take a peek.
Go ahead, Jonathan.
All right, listen up.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Here today.
Listen up.
Go ahead.
You can take this prize now, or you can take it later. You could be an aviator. I say, lady, what you gonna do to your piggy babies? I say, Gucci, coochie, coo.
Behind my curtain, girl, there's loving. Because you're a pig, it's hotter than an oven. What's behind there? It might be good for you.
I told you, Wayne, she wants the box, not the curtain.
Girl, it's mine. Privilege to cool things down like one might do with the fridge.
He might be lying or be faking, but my box has got the real bacon.
She wants my curtain.
She wants the box.
She wants my box. Curtain.
She wants the box.
Baby, what, tell me, what do you want my curtain?
That's an audition. That's not a TV show, right?
Yeah, basically, yeah.
Well, I know you've known Wayne before you started this, but did you develop this chemistry since you started this show, or did you start way back?
We knew each other when we were teenagers back in Orlando, Florida. We started doing improv together at a place called Sack Theater Comedy Lab, and we did a bunch of shows there. And then we moved out to L.A., and this was our improv group.
You look the same, okay? You haven't changed. Look at this.
This was our group.
You look the same.
We were called the House Full of Honkies, which was our and then Wayne, of course, has the high top there, which is awesome.
He looks the same too.
But we've been doing shows forever together. And then right after he got Whose Line, he went on the road and said, you know, you're coming with me. And so every time he's had a job, whether it's been his talk show or his variety show or Let's Make a Deal, he's like, hey, come do the show with me. I've never announced anything in my life, and here I am on network television describing a Prius. I've never done that ever, but he's so loyal to me.
How do you get it? Because outside of the improv and whatnot, let's get into your sort of your personal life. Sort of thing. You know, well, that's where the real heart of the matter is. That's where the Jonathan lies. How are you with like your dad, right?
Yeah. Two boys.
Two boys.
Yeah.
Oh, so then you do men things. You take the kids out and you do the.
Man things better. Like, I'm so bad at man things. Like fixing and tools and hiking and eating beef jerky. I'm not good at any. My wife Leah, her father was a mechanic for the Chicago Police Department, and he's into tools. And he sent us for a birthday present a 6 foot tall, 4 foot wide toolkit. This is the toolkit.
Awesome.
Like I'm this tall. And he keeps bringing me tools and I don't know how to use any of this stuff. I just stick it in there, and I think he thinks it's going to teach me how to be a man, but I'm
so
not.
So you don't teach your boys how to use that?
Oh, I put holes in things. Stuff catches on fire. It's not good.
They're boys though. What are their ages?
They are 9 and 11. Chase and Austin.
That's my guys. They sports. They do the
there
whole
they
thing.
Are. There's Chase and there's Austin.
Oh, beautiful.
And my
family.
Wife Leah.
Beautiful
are they athletic?
Family.
Do they want to get? Because boys want to, you know, climb.
They
are. And do whatever. They
love sports. They love soccer. Yeah. I don't know anything about sports.
We were talking in the dressing room, remember? Because we're so fired up about Super Bowl, and you were saying you know nothing about sports.
I don't know
sports.
Any. Like if you want to talk about video games or Dungeons and Dragons or Doctor Who, I'm your guy.
That's what we're doing.
And it's funny because like other parents.
You know who you are.
Other parents will walk up to me and go, "Hey, how about the game?" And my kids are standing there next to me, but I'll like pretend. I'll be like, "Yeah, how about that run by that?" And my kids are like, "You are so full of it, Dad. Just stop."
So you're a dungeon master.
Well, I have been a dungeon master.
Did you win? Yeah.
The dungeon master doesn't win. They keep the game.
Sorry.
Shut down, baby. You've been shut down.
It's okay. Everyone just changed the channel.
Except for two guys who stumbled with their mother, right?
Exactly.
In the basement.
In the basement.
So do your kids sense your sense of humor? Do they understand how funny you are?
I think they do. I think so. I mean, it's funny because they'll do things that are funny but are inappropriate. And so I have to, as a dad, I can't laugh at their inappropriate joke, even though it's funny, because then you're training them to do that, and they'll go to school and do it and get in trouble. But at the same time, you know, you want to let them know, that's funny, dude. Don't you?
Great timing.
Yeah, it's good timing. It's good timing. But
do you play improvisational games with them? And what is improv anyway? What is that?
Improv is just making things up. And there's a couple rules that are always important to improv. It's yes and. Always say yes and add something to it. So if I say, I'm the president, you can't say, no, you're not. You'd have to say yes and we're being invaded. Then I'd say, yes, let's get the army to, you move the story forward. You can't block somebody, which is like, saying if whatever
denying
they say,
something.
Denying them. And then you can't wimp on something. If someone says, climb that mountain right now, you can't go, okay, I'm here. You got to, make a big deal of it and climb the mountain. There's a fun game that we could play. Actually, I could show you
little
improv. Yeah, like right now.
Do you do this with your kids?
Yeah, this is a game I do with my kids, actually.
Man.
It's called Who Wants to Do It With Me?
We love a game.
This is real simple. It's called One Word at a Time Story. You were just going to tell a story, but we can only go one word at a time, okay?
Okay.
Okay, you guys want to be on that, too?
Sure.
So go this way, come around.
Okay, okay.
So once.
Upon.
A time.
No, one word. Ooh. That's okay. You're out. Ready? Here we go. Once.
I.
Went.
To.
The.
Store.
And. I.
Smelled.
Caca.
That's a store you don't want to go to.
And is that two words?
That is, you're out. That's two words.
It's not. It's one whole word.
I can imagine. Wonderful, wonderful game to play with kids, though.
Because it's fun.
My kids speak in one-word sentences all the time. I'm trying to get them to go past
that. How does that game end?
The story will come to an end, or you'll say, or it ends in caca.
You can see Jonathan on Let's Make a Deal, weekday CBS, and as a recurring comedian on Whose Line Is It Anyway on the CW. Really? Really? You just said that on television. We're going in the kitchen next, and we're going to hang out with Chef Brooke Williamson and her adorable son, Hudson.